indirect inference is rarely used in practice. Instead, most people use a variation called two-stage least squares, or 2SLS. Now, this is a really good keyword to keep your eye out for, because you know that if somebody writes 2SLS or two-stage least squares, then they're using an instrumental variables strategy. Now, I'm not going to go into the details about exactly how this estimator works, but I'll give you a little bit of intuition to see how it uses the main idea behind instrumental variables. Now, in the name of the estimator, two-stage least squares, you know that there's going to be two steps. So, the first step is that you get the first stage effect of the instrument on the treatment. So that's exactly what we did with the indirect inference estimator before. The difference here is that we're going to use that first stage effect to create a new variable called the adjusted treatment variable. And how do we do that? Well, we take our treatment variable. Now, it's explained by a lot of other variables, including the instrument, meaning there are a lot of variables that cause the treatment. We're going to take the treatment and split it into two pieces, the part explained by the instrument and the part explained by everything else. Now, the part explained by the instrument, we're going to call the adjusted treatment variable. Now, because we assumed the instrument satisfied the exogeneity assumption, it's basically randomly assigned, that part of the treatment explained by the instrument is also exogenous. It's also randomly assigned. So we can just look at, in the second step, the correlation between the adjusted treatment and the outcome variable. And that correlation is exactly the treatment effect we want. And that's all there is to the two-stage least squares estimator.